Welcome back to Talk with Gaetano. If you just joined me, my goodness, what an interesting conversation we're having with Esther Kalenzi, founder of 40 Days Over 40 Smiles. Just go on Facebook, you'll find them. Go on Twitter. I'm sure they're on all these media platforms online. Well, back to you, Esther. This is our last segment, so we'll try and squeeze in as much or squeeze out as much from you as possible. Very quickly, we just talked about your funding for your organization being all locally based. Yeah. Do you think you will, now that you've done 5 years locally, you see how it is on the ground here, will you eventually go to these international donors and ask? I mean, there's nothing wrong. You've done it here. Yeah. Broaden your scope.
Yeah. I have completely no problem with broadening our scope to include international funders. Mm. And I can tell you that, yeah. A golden handshake would change so many things for us, yeah? Mm. Because we have big dreams and we know we can achieve them, but sometimes you're limited by funding. And sometimes it's your own people don't believe in you, so what are you going to do, yeah? Or they are more interested in, more business, exciting entrepreneurship things and not this that we are doing.
Right.
So we do know that we can seek funding from outside, but that's after we have exhausted all possible alternatives here at home, So we have plans to introduce a business arm of 40/40.
Okay.
That where 50% will fund the business and 50% will fund the projects. Mm-hmm. So that in that way, I'm not going to join Gaetano, Hillary, and whoever and asking them to fund. I can, but then there will also be something there.
Okay.
So that way I can employ someone and then I can pay them a salary, because for a long time they've just, we've lived on goodwill and passion, and passion doesn't put food on the table.
Passion does not feed you, I'm telling you, unless it's passion fruit. It's joking.
Good one. Yes, so we want to exhaust as many alternative sources of funding as we possibly can.
Okay.
But then all this is so that, these kids can get a better life and we can expand and do much more, because I think we've done a considerable amount of work even with the little resources that we've managed to get. So imagine what it would be if we expand it.
Are you talking about the work that you've been doing, and you've touched the hearts of many young children out of there who don't have the things that other families might have?
Yeah.
What are some of the successful stories that you've had since you started 40/40?
Where does one begin?
I'm sure you have quite a few. One that maybe stands out, I'm sure they all have a place in your heart, but maybe give us an example of one of them.
Okay, let me just give an example. The year was 2013, and we had just concluded a partnership with one community, and we were looking to serve another one. Mm. So someone comes and tells us, oh, I know this school in Luwero, it looks after orphan children, some are even disabled, they're deaf, they, broken limbs, and, just check them out and see what you can offer. And at that point, we had sort of created a name for ourselves. So every day, there was someone has cancer, brain tumor, what? And we could not handle all these things. Mm. And unfortunately, when you are in a position like I am, you suddenly want to. You know you can't, but you want to, because you're going to continue thinking about that child.
Right.
Yeah, or you're going to think about the person who, by the time they called you, they really had no other alternative.
Right.
So we go visit the school, and you could see they had little, but they were using it, like they were actually doing their best. They weren't just sitting there and doing nothing. They're like, oh, we are planning to plant some things here. We're planning to do this. So they also had big dreams. And like us, they were starting from nowhere. Mm. And so I was endeared to what they had. So they had a small room like this. Mm. And in that room, there were babies. In that room, there were toddlers. In that room, there were 10-year-olds. In that room, there were teens. And that's where they slept. That's wrong on so many different levels.
It is.
Yeah?
It is.
And so we're like, but what's the plan? And they're like, we've been planning to build a dormitory, but, resources and all these things. So just out of, I'm just asking. I'm not saying I'm doing anything, but what's your budget? So they say, we have a budget of 28 million. I choked because I think the most we had raised by that time was like 4M. Yeah.
I'm gonna fast forward.
Yeah.
28 million.
Yes.
To help them achieve building a dormitory.
Yes.
The long and the short of this.
Yes.
You and your organization.
Yes.
Can I guess? Can I hazard a guess? No, did you raise that money?
Yes, we did.
You raised 28 million.
We were able to raise 28 million shillings and put up a dormitory for 210 children.
Bonga. Bonga. What?
Yes.
Where was this?
It's in Luwero. It's called Luwero. Happy Times.
Happy Times.
Yes. Now, that was our first big eat. That was our first, yes, you can do it. Stop playing small. Stop undermining your potential. Ugandans are kind. Ugandans want to give. So many people need you. And, you know, it was an eye-opener. Because when that happened, it was just Facebook, Twitter, and a few messages. And we had the money and a few events to raise the money. And it was there. And then the building was there. And then the children moved in and they're there. And they'll be there 30 years after I'm out of this world, hopefully.
Wow.
So
wow.
I think for me, that was the beginning of, you know, there's no turning back. There are going to be hard times. It's going to be difficult.
Wow.
But you're doing this and you're going to do it.
You know, you started off saying here, people look at you as if Mother Teresa or what? No, your Mother Esther. Mother Esther. What are you working on now? It's 2017.
Yeah.
You've seen the way Uganda, Kampala is, Banang. There's a lot happening.
Yes.
What are you targeting this year?
Okay, so so many things, so many. I told you we are turning five, so the pressure is really on. Now, okay, I started the Facebook page in February, but then the Easter weekend is like when we actually launched and did something. So after the Easter weekend this year, we are planning to have like a huge fundraising dinner where we shall showcase what we've done for the past 5 years and now introduce the world to the wild dream, like what we are planning to do for the next five. So that's actually what we are working on right now. But in between that, we are still running the literacy projects. When the term begins, we'll be back in the schools in Kibuli. Every Friday, we are with the children, reading, writing. Which word don't you understand? Let's help you. Are you shy? We understand that, but maybe you have another skill. What's that skill at? Let us help you bring out, express yourself through art. We are going to have our usual fundraisers because that's the time when we engage the youth and bring them into one place and get to actually help. Yeah, you've been busy the whole time. You've been going to work, but now this is your opportunity to mingle with us, get to know what we are doing.
Right.
And hopefully at the end of the year, we want to launch or have finally, a learning center. And this learning center, we're going to have several of them all over, but this learning center is a one-stop place where children have free access to books, to
that
all kinds of educational material, games, computer.
That's going to cost a lot more than 28 million, my friend.
Yes, it is. But
a lot more.
It is, but we believe everything is possible. We're going to make it happen.
Have you ever approached government to assist you in any of the work that you're doing? Has any government spokesperson or person or MP or president ever come to say, listen, we like what you're doing, we're going to help you out, ever?
Can I tell you a weird story related to what you just asked? After the elections last year, I got a phone call
from
a personal assistant of an MP.
Mm-hmm.
And first of all, I was held back. Yes, I was like, how did you get my number? That's it. After the shock, he was like, oh, so 4040, we've had the work that you do. What? So I'm going to give hypothetically. Let us say Nakasongola. So he says, our MP Nakasongola would like you to come and help us build schools and run all the projects that you've been doing with your funding.
With your funding?
Yes. So 4040, which are we are millionaires, obviously.
I mean, of course.
We have like billions to spend,
yeah.
And we're looking for places to put it.
Yes.
So, hey, come and put the...
I mean,
put
billionaires,
yes. Come and construct things.
Like that.
Yet, I'm sorry, you're going to earn 25 million and you have a budget for your constituency, but hey, come and do this.
With your funding.
Yes.
You laughed.
I almost cried. It was very sad.
That
it broke my heart. It really, really broke my heart. Because, yes, we've tried to get into rooms and conversations with people and ask them how we can work together, and they have turned us down. And that's fine, we've moved on. But here is someone saying, hey, we want to ride on your good name. We are not going to do anything for our constituents after promising them heaven on earth during the voting. Now that we are in office, please come and do this so that we shall, you know,
so we can shine.
Yeah, we shall sign it off as our work. And you guys can go on about your business.
How embarrassing, how shocking, how disgusting is that?
Yeah, it's repulsive. Like, I could not believe it, but then at the same time, worse things have happened.
You know, at the same time, you can't believe it, and at the same time, this being Uganda,
you can't believe it. Exactly. So you don't want to believe it, but then you're like, it was only a matter of time.
Only a matter of time. Yeah. Well, you know what? I'm going to give you an opportunity. There's your camera. I want you, this is your chance to kalango and just say, you know, give us your email address, your phone numbers, your WhatsApp, your Facebook, your Instagram, to sort of let people know the work that you're doing. And if they are interested in sort of donating or giving their time voluntarily, why not? Go ahead.
All right. So the 40 Days Over 40 Smiles Foundation tagline is be the change you want to see in the world. Be the change. You can be the change at work, at home, with your families, in your community, anywhere. All you have to do is practice exactly what you want to see. If you want a cleaner society, do that. If you want less corrupt officials, do not be corrupt. If you want to be able to see a difference, you yourself have the power to start with it, because at the end of the day, it begins with you. My team and I have decided that this is our life's mission, to improve the lives of vulnerable children in Uganda. We know we can do it, but we can't do it on our own. We need your support, any kind of support. We need skills, we need time, we need finances. We have so many dreams, so many programs that we are running, but we can't do it alone. If you would like to get in touch with us, you can visit our website, which is 40daysover40smiles.org. That is 40daysover40smiles.org. You can find us on Facebook and like our page. It's 40 Days Over 40 Smiles. Or follow us on Twitter. It's 40days_40smiles. We look forward to hearing from you. We have so much up our sleeve, but we can't do it alone. And like we've said during the show, we really, 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 really want to have 100% Ugandan funding, and we know we can do it, because we're Ugandans, we're after our own people, and we need to make them happy, and we can't do it on our own. So support us. Ask us how you can support. But even if you've not supported 40 Days Over 40 Smiles, there are lots and lots of projects in Uganda, lots of people who need your help. Just come together and be there for them.
Manange, you should run for a position as an MP. The way you've spoken so passionately, that is really good. You know what? Charity does begin at home. Okay. So from me, and I'm going to try to even squeeze some of my people here, I'm going to give 50,000 shillings towards the 40 Days Over 40 Smiles.
Thank you.
Just to sort of show that I'm also not that hard. I'm going to try. And I'm not trying to shine. I'm going to give it to you and say thank you so much. Esther Kalenzi, 40 Days Over 40 Smiles. Continue doing the good work that you are doing. You heard what she said. So go over there and support and do what you can for Uganda. Don't be like some MPs, not all, who try to just ride on other people's thing. Do something just like you've done, Esther. So thank you so much indeed.
Thank you too.
All right, that's our show this evening. Talk with Gaetano. We'll be back tomorrow. Thank you so much for being with us, and keep it on Urban Television. Bye-bye.